The last videos were rather technical and introduced you to the concept of Raman signal and noise. This time, I will explain why the spectral resolution should also be part of your considerations.
Raman peaks have a natural width from molecular motions and inhomogeneities. That means, even with an ideal instrument, most Raman peaks will still be wider than 10 wave numbers. So, in a sense, the value of the instrument's spectral resolution is benchmarked by the peak broadening. If this value of our Raman spectrometer is too high, we are going to lose the capability of distinguishing peaks that are close by, or we don't notice if a peak's position changes slightly. But how is the spectral resolution determined? It's mainly decided by four factors: the size of the entrance slit of the spectrometer, the line density of the grating, the focal length of the spectrometer, and the format of the CCD. Normally, we can only influence the first two, and the latter two are fixed for a spectrometer. If we change the slit and make it narrower, we can improve the spectral resolution. At the same time, however, we reduce the amount of light reaching the CCD, and thus we lose sensitivity. We can also change the grating and increase the so-called line density. This spreads the Raman signal over a wider angular range, improving the spectral resolution, but again, less light will reach the individual CCD pixels and we lose sensitivity. In summary, the best spectral resolution will always come at the price of a less optimal signal-to-noise ratio and measurement speed. We simply cannot have both of them at the same time. Next time, we will continue with the topic of selection of gratings line density.